My question is to the Minister representing the Prime Minister, Senator Corman. In 2016, 17, 19 and 20, I cross-examined CSIRO's climate research team on four presentations to me. That revealed CSIRO has never said carbon dioxide from human activity is a danger. CSIRO admitted today's temperatures are not unprecedented. CSIRO's cited papers do not show rate of temperature rise is unprecedented. CSIRO has never quantified any specific impact from human carbon dioxide. CSIRO relies on unvalidated, erroneous models. CSIRO relied on discredited papers. CSIRO showed little understanding of papers cited. CSIRO admits to no due diligence on reports and data. CSIRO allows politicians to misrepresent CSIRO without correction. 15 highly respected international scientists verified our conclusions. What is the basis for the government's climate and energy policies?
The Minister representing the Prime Minister, Senator Cormann.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. The basis of our commitment is, as part of the international community, doing our bit to help reduce global greenhouse gas emissions. That's the basis. We are committed to a sensible climate change policy which appropriately balances environmental protection with economic responsibility. That has always been our position. And as a country, we have not only met, but we have exceeded our emissions reduction targets agreed to in Kyoto, and we are on track and have a plan to meet our emissions reduction targets agreed to in Paris. I mean, we are a good global citizen. There is a global challenge that needs to be addressed, and we are doing our bit sensibly and responsibly and proportionately to contribute to meeting that challenge. In relation to the CSIRO specifically, CSIRO is a national treasure. It undertakes essential science and research which improves our lives and helps grow our economy. CSIRO stands behind its researchers and the integrity of the research produced by them. Their demonstrated record of scientific excellence is underpinned by their commitment to the full and transparent participation in the scientific peer review process, which results in evidence-based science of the highest quality, including making data publicly available. CSIRO is in the top 0.1% of the world for its four core fields of science and in the world's top 1% for the other 14 fields. They rank in the top three of the world's national science agencies for impact. And I note that the CSIRO has provided briefings to Senator Roberts in the past, and I also note that Senator Roberts has asked a number of questions which CSIRO has responded to and will, of course, continue to respond to moving forward. I hope that appropriately addresses Senator Roberts' question.
I thank senators for their courtesy during Senator Roberts' question, and I ask for it again. Senator Roberts, a supplementary question.
Thank you. Your ministers for climate and energy and preceding Liberal Nationals and Labor Greens governments claimed that climate and renewable energy policies are based on CSIRO advice. Yet CSIRO's climate team admitted to me that CSIRO has never stated carbon dioxide from human activity is a danger, and when asked for the source of that political claim, suggested I ask politicians and ministers. On what basis is your government claiming we need to cut the carbon dioxide from farming, industry, transport and driving cars?
Senator Cormann.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. There is a recognised global challenge which we believe needs to be appropriately addressed in a global fashion through an appropriately comprehensive global arrangement, and Australia, as a responsible international citizen, is committed to doing its bit, and that is precisely what our government is doing. Under our government, emissions are coming down and electricity prices are also coming down. And we are keeping the lights on, bringing electricity prices down and helping to reduce global greenhouse gas emissions in a way that is economically responsible. And we are very proud of our record, and we remain committed to that as the appropriate way forward.
Senator Roberts, a final supplementary question.
Thank you. The CSIRO climate research team's position ultimately relies on unvalidated and erroneous computer models that are not suitable as a basis for policy, in implying falsely that they have confidence in the models, yet have never assigned a quantitative calculated confidence level. CSIRO has misled you. Will your government hold an independent inquiry into the so-called science that is supposedly the basis of your climate and energy policies?
Senator Corman.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. I think I've clearly stated the basis for the government's decision-making in relation to these areas. And I might just say again that as Australians, we are rightly proud of the CSIRO. The CSIRO is a world-class organisation. Now, that doesn't mean that every bit of research is immediately right on the mark. But the CSIRO, like any scientific organisation, understands that any research has to be appropriately tested and peer-reviewed, and they are absolutely committed to the appropriate rigours and transparencies that apply to any scientific organisations of this nature, and that is, of course, appropriate. We completely support the important work the CSIRO does and continue to stand by it.